Oh no, that kid fell out of the tree. Somebody called an ambulance. Where is his parents? What happened?
Oh no!
Hello?
Hello, is this Brandon's father? He's been in a terrible accident and he's in the emergency room and you have to come right away.
Oh, really? I'll be right there.
Brandon!
Son, please be okay. Sir, do you mind if I come in and talk to you for a little bit about your son?
Yeah, what happened to him?
Well, he was outside playing, and he fell from a tree. And that's what got us interested. It was only about a 4-foot drop, which is why we're concerned that in that drop, what happened? He dislocated his shoulder, ripped a tendon completely out, and broke a few ribs. Now, normally, this would happen from, I'd say, a 20-foot drop, at his age especially. But he lost a lot of blood, and when we were getting the replacement blood, we found something interesting. You know, his levels were all off, and we suspect that your son may have blood cancer. Now, one option that we have to help combat this is experimental and new stem cell treatment. If you want to take a look through that pamphlet, I can also help explain it a little better.
This is pretty interesting. Is this relatively new?
You know, stem cell research is pretty new. Within the past 5 to 10 years, we've made some major breakthroughs, going to experimental phases. So, yeah, they are pretty new.
That's pretty intriguing, because my wife died from this a few years back, and they didn't tell me anything about this.
Yeah, we wouldn't have been using it back then. It's still experimental now. Why don't we go to my office? We can talk about it a little more. All right, this way. Take a seat.
Okay.
Now, first let me catch you up to speed on what stem cells actually are. Stem cells have the potential to develop into any other type of cell, be it nerve, skin, blood in your case. And now they do this through replication, and there's 4 types of stem cells, but we're going to be focusing on one mainly, and that's embryonic. Now, that's taken from a developing fetus, nothing to worry about. And what we're going to do is we're going to take those cells, we're going to put them in, we're going to fuse them in with your son's blood. And what that'll do is that'll help fight off the cancer, that'll help make it stronger, and that'll help him overcome it so he's on his way back to being a kid again.
I heard you mention embryonic cells, and that involves embryos. So is abortion happening?
You know, there's no abortion that needs to take place in order for us to get the cells that we need out of that embryo. What happens is we have some in vitro fertilized eggs that have been stored. They're frozen. You know, they don't need them anymore. So either we're going to take them, throw them away, we get no use out of them. Or what we can do is we take them, put them to good use for your son, put them in his blood. They'll fight it off. You know, they'll repair, replace all the damaged cells. He'll be back to normal. It all depends on what you feel an abortion is. If you feel it's a moral life that's getting taken, it's all about your religion.
Yeah, we're a really religious family. Can we have some time to think about this decision?
It's a big decision, so I'll let you have all the time that you need.
Okay, thank you.
Stand to fly. I'm not that naive. I'm just out to find the better part of me.
My son, stand up.
Brother of Christ, what brings you here?
My son got in a serious accident.
Brandon, what has happened to the young lad?
He has blood cancer, but there is hope.
My golly, blood cancer at this young of an age? That's just a shame. Isn't that the same thing your wife had?
Yeah.
And you're telling me of hope. There is hope. Of course there is hope, but what kind of hope are you talking about?
Stem cells. They are.
Stem cells? Now let me tell you about stem cells.
Now let me give you some background information on stem cells, especially embryonic stem cells. Now in order to create embryonic stem cells, the death and removal of a fetus from the female womb must occur. Now if you leave that fetus in there and let it mature for about 9 months, eventually you will have a baby. And this can be considered almost abortion, and this is why us as a community and as a church, we don't believe in this kind of use.
Yeah, but Father, it's the only way.
Let me tell you, my piece of advice would be to put this in the hands of God and just continually have faith and just trust in Him.
Excuse me, Doctor. I think I've decided I want to do the stem cell treatment.
Very well, that's a good choice. We'll get him started. Oh, I'm sorry to interrupt, but it's time for me to administer to your son.
My dad.
Hello, Brandon. My name is Dr. Paulson. I'm going to fix you up today. So what happened is your blood had some bad things in it. Now we're going to put some good things in it, and they're going to fight it off, and you'll be back to normal. You know, we won't have any more bad alleys. It should be fine. Alright, let's get you going, champ.
Hi, I'm Dr. Paul H. Kolb. I'm here to talk about stem cells. Stem cells have been developed over the last 30 years, and they really have a remarkable history. In the early age of stem cells, when I was still in medical practice, they were mostly embryonic stem cells, and that raised quite a few ethical concerns. However, nowadays, you can get stem cells from four different types of material. And that kind of lessens the ethical concerns, and I think it makes it much more useful for everyday research. Currently, there's over 60 diseases that can be treated with stem cells, from simple things as blood dyscrasias to multiple sclerosis, brain and spinal cord injuries. So it's just really beginning to get started with the research into stem cells. But their value over the next many years will be phenomenal, and I think they'll have far-reaching implications for treatment and prevention of diseases. I think with the changes in stem cells and the way they're manufactured now, I highly endorse stem cell research and their uses, and in the future I think they'll do great things, and I strongly recommend them and endorse them. Paul H. Kolb, DL.